What's the best financial advice you can give to an aspiring entrepreneur?
Yo, cash flow. Look after your cash flow. I think there's a lot of entrepreneurs that's got good ideas that they maybe take too much money out of their business too soon, or they can't really proceed with it to something that, and the quality that needed to be done because there's a shortage of cash flow. So if you can get that right, it's much easier to do business.
And it's something that I've always been bad at. I think as entrepreneurs, at least in my own life, I've been willing to spend a lot of money to make money, which is also important, knowing that, you know, especially online, it's easy to start these days, but because there's so many things happening, it's difficult to get the attention of people. And a great way of doing that is to pay to play.
Okay.
So on the one hand, you have to really just be pedantic about where your money is going. On the other hand, you have to be willing to invest into your business to get the returns.
Don't spend your cash, even when, because that's what maturity is actually about. It's about saying no to good opportunities in the pursuit of even better ones.
Yeah.
So the way that you pursue even better ones is by having cash to spend.
Sure.
And it's very easy once you start making money to go, oh, well, that's fancy. I'm going to go and buy that. Or I'm going to get a nicer car. Or I'm going to get an office when you don't need one. You know what I mean? It's actually about preparing yourself for the eventualities that you don't know is coming yet. So it's an insurance policy. So I'd say from a financial perspective, it's like do your best not to spend your cash until you really do have runway to work with.
Be frugal. Be so frugal. Everything adds up. So I made all the mistakes possible when I started being an entrepreneur. I quit my job too soon. I got an office space. I hired too soon. I made every single spending mistake you can possibly think of. So just save. And before you start, make sure that you can at least cover yourself for 6 months personally. And you also have 6 months spending for a company, minimum.
Yeah.
And have a plan. Have a plan of bootstrapping. What are you good at? What can you sell while you're trying to do this? So I consult. I have a furniture business online. So I have all these little mini revenue streams yes. coming in. And all of that helps me to build a buffer to make sure that my core, my flagship company, my NT Trips, has runway.
So before you become an entrepreneur, have a little bit of backup, because a business takes about 12 to 18 months to build and to break even. And you don't want to be stressing all day, every day, that you don't have money to pay the bills. So have money in your, have some money or some runway in your backup. And also so that you don't have to sell your equity in your business at a very early stage, because you're not going to get a very good price.
Yeah.